We welcome you back. It is 7:45. Okay, what were you doing when you were 15 years old? Hanging out with friends, maybe, figuring out life? Well, our next guest writes a political newsletter every single day and blasts it out before 8 a.m., all from his U City home. And yes, he is 15 years old. We welcome Gabe Fleischer, editor-in-chief of a newsletter called Wake Up to Politics, daily newsletter filled with all the latest political buzz. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
You're really 15.
I
kind of was interested in politics too, but not like this. First of all, got to ask you the St. Louis question. What high school do you go to?
I go to John Burroughs.
There you go. There you go. And you have this newsletter that gets blasted out every day. How many people are subscribed to your newsletter?
Now over 33,000 readers.
And I think you had a little help from some national media.
That's correct.
You've been published where?
So I just recently, there's a profile in the New York Times, which greatly expanded my readership, and also on CNN. So it's been an exciting week.
It's pretty, yeah, I would say so. Now talk about some of your followers, because I sort of looked at some of the tweets and some things that people are talking about. You're getting some big journalism names there,
yeah,
too.
A lot
let's,
of big...
let's name drop here, Gabe.
A lot of big journalists. Major Garrett, who's the chief White House correspondent at CBS, a lot of top people at CNN, at the Washington Post, a lot of big journalists and politicians, but also a lot of school teachers, a lot
right.
of people who are less engaged in politics, which means a lot to me that they're also reading and sharing with their students or their children.
Why are you so interested in politics?
You know, I've been interested in politics really since the 2008 elections, and you know, just during election times when politics is all around us, and I got really interested and curious, and I've always loved to read and write. So I started sending a newsletter to my mom when I was like 9, and just grown and grown from there.
You sent it to your mom to start, and it's
my first subscriber.
And it really is well written. You're getting some kudos for how well you're doing. And I guess are your teachers at John Burroughs kind of, you know, say, okay, brush up on this. Do they grade your paper?
No, they don't. They have enough of mine to grade.
Oh, gotcha. All right, got to ask you this question. Is it partisan?
It's no, completely nonpartisan newsletter. At least I try to be, because I think that's very important to stay credible, and and people tell me that I do a good job at it, so that's what I always try
but
to do.
But let's be honest, you're going to get some folks who accuse you of being partisan, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
And do they?
I get people from both sides, though, which to me, that tells me I'm doing something right.
You are in politics. So with all this said, would you ever eyeball maybe a run for office?
Maybe. Right now, I'm really enjoying being a journalist, and that's what I'd like to do for as long as I can, but you never know.
So basically, when you blast out your newsletter, which, by the way, is due out in, what, 10 minutes,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I gotta finish it.
Sorry. We'll hurry it along. You got to blast it out here in 10 minutes. You got a big week coming up in politics, so you talk
sure.
about what happened yesterday and what's going to happen today. I see moments ago you responded to one of President Trump's tweets, right?
Yeah, always.
So you keep your eye on all of it.
For sure.
All right.
And these days, every day, every minute, there's something new, a new tweet or a new story, so it's a lot of fun to keep up with and try to help inform
a
people.
Lot going on in Washington this week, no doubt. Yeah. Do you focus on local politics as well?
Mostly just national politics, you know, White House, Congress, and elections.
All right, I'm gonna be remembering the day when I said I interviewed him. I remember him. I remember that. So, all right. Well, good luck to you.
Thank you.
And we'll be following you, of course. And best of luck. It should be great.
Thank you so much.
All right, and we're gonna take a break. He's got a newsletter to get out. We gotta go. We'll be right back.